So in this lecture, we are going to discuss some simple problems based on ratio and proportion. So all of us know that a ratio will be written in the form of A upon B, or it is also written in this fashion, A is to B. Okay, so this is nothing but the ratio. For example, simple ratio is, say, I say 2 is to 7. So this is the ratio. 2 is to 7 means what? It is in the fashion of 2 by 7, 2 upon 7. Here A is called antecedent and B is called consequent. Okay, now suppose I have, instead of having two numbers, okay, so these are only two numbers, A and B. Now suppose I am having three numbers. So suppose I take the three numbers A, B and C. If I'm saying that these three numbers are in proportion, okay, now I'm talking about proportion. These three numbers are in proportion. What is the meaning of these three numbers are in proportion? The meaning of three numbers A, B, C are in proportion is that if you take A divided by B, means if you take A upon B, and if you take B upon C, means first you take these two people, and the other time you take these two people, then you take B upon C. Okay, then A upon C and B upon C will come out to be what? They will come out to be equal. Okay, so if A upon B and B upon C come equal, then you will say that the three numbers are in proportion. Okay, let me take one simple example, right? So suppose I take the three numbers are, suppose 3, 12 and 4. Okay, so A upon B is 3 upon 12 and B upon C is how much? B upon C is 12 upon 4. Now we know that this 3 upon 12 I can cancel. 3 ones are 3 and 3 fours are 12 on the right hand side, and on the other side I have 4 ones are 4 and 4 threes are 12. So what is A upon B equal to? A upon B is equal to 1 upon 4. Okay, and what is B upon C equal to? B upon C is equal to how much? 3 upon 1. 3 upon 1 means 3, right? And what is 1 upon 4? 1 upon 4 means it is a fraction, 1 fourth upon, right? We call it as a fraction, means 1 by 4th, quarter. You say it as quarter, right? So these two numbers are clearly not equal, right? So this means that A upon B is not equal to what? Is not equal to B upon C. Therefore, these three numbers A, B, C, what were the three numbers? The three numbers were 3, 12 and 4. 3, 12 and 4, these are not in proportion. Therefore, 3, 12 and 4 are not in proportion. Okay. Now let us go to four numbers. So instead of having three numbers, now I'm taking the third point. The third point is take four numbers now. So for four numbers, so let me take the four numbers A, B, C and D. Okay. So the four numbers A, B, C, D are said to be in proportion if, now I will have a similar condition like the above ones. Now what I will have is A upon B is equal to, it must be equal to how much? It must be equal to C upon D. Okay, so if A upon B is some number and C upon D is some number, these two numbers must be equal. Only then I will say that these two numbers are in what? These two numbers are in proportion. So what is the example of that? Let me take four numbers now. Okay, suppose I take 4, 12, 3 and 9. Okay, are they in proportion? This is my question. Okay, I'm asking this question. So how will I check this now? So what is A here? A is 4. B is how much? B is 12. C is 3 and D is 9. So what is A upon B? Let us calculate what is A upon B. A upon B is equal to how much? And C upon D is equal to how much? What is A upon B? 4 upon 12. And what is C upon D? 3 upon 9. Now I can cancel this. So by using the table of 4, I can say that 4 1 the 4 and 4 3 the 12. So this is equal to how much? This is 1/3. This is 1 upon 3. Correct. And on the right hand side, again, I have to cancel 3 1 the 3 and 3 3 the 9. So this is also equal to how much? This is also 1/3. Means I got that A upon B is also 1/3 and B upon C is, or C upon D is also 1/3. And therefore, now I can say that A upon B is equal to C upon D. And therefore, what can I say? Therefore, the four numbers, what were the four numbers? The four numbers were 4, 12, 3 and 9. Therefore, 4, 12, 3 and 9 are in proportion. Okay. Now here in this, when I have these four numbers, okay, when I have the four numbers, these four numbers A, B, C and D, okay, out of from these four numbers, this A and D are at extreme positions. Correct, means they are at the corners. Extreme position means one is either first and D is the last. Since A and D are in the first and the last positions, which are called extreme positions, they are called what? Extremals. A and D are called extremals. You have to remember these small words. Okay, extremals means they are at the extreme position. When I'm taking three numbers, when I have discussed about three numbers, were what? A, B and C. I hope you remember what is the condition for three numbers to be in proportion. The condition was A upon B is equal to how much? B upon C. Okay, in this case, this middle number, the center, that number is called as mean proportional. It has two, three names. It is called mean proportional, or it is also called as geometric mean. Any word people use, geometric mean of which two numbers? Of A and C. So B is the geometric mean of what? A and C, or B is the mean proportional of A and C. Okay, so we have to solve different problems based on the four numbers in proportion, based on three numbers in proportion. Okay, so now we will solve a problem that if X upon Y is equal to 3 upon 5, okay, and Y is equal to 20, then find X. Okay, now let us see how to solve this simple problem. So X upon Y is equal to 3 upon 5. This is the same question I have copied down. Now in the next step, what I will do is I will write X upon how much is Y? Y is equal to how much? Y is 20. So X upon 20. So instead of Y, I have written 20 is equal to 3 upon Y. Right? And I want to find what? I want to find X. Now I will send this 5 on the left hand side and multiply it there. So I will write X multiplied by 5 is equal to, I will send this 20 on that side and I will write 3 multiplied by 20. Okay, I have sent 5 to the left hand side and I have sent 20 to the right hand side. And I want to find X. I want to find this person. So this means that this 5 I will send on the right hand side back. I want X alone, right? So I want to keep X alone. So this means that X is equal to 3 multiplied by 20 divided by this 5 is multiplied here. So when I send it to the right hand side, it will go and divide. It will be upon 5. Now I will cancel. So I know that 5 ones are 5 and 5 fours are 20. So what am I left with? X is equal to 3 multiplied by 4 upon 1, which is 12 upon 1. Means it is 12. 12 upon 1 means how much? 12. So what is X equal to? Finally, the answer of X is equal to how much? X is equal to 12. Okay. So this is what we wanted to solve.